Should you buy an RTX 3060 gaming laptop, or can you save some money on an older RTX 2070? I've compared both laptop GPUs in 17 different games at both 1080p and 1440p resolutions to show you all the differences. These are the differences in specs between these two laptop GPUs. The RTX 3060 came out 2 years after the 2070 and has 67% more CUDA cores with a higher boost clock speed. The older 2070 has more total VRAM capacity and the memory is faster too. Nvidia's newer 30 series also has additional features that 20 series is missing though, like resizable bar and dynamic boost. Performance will vary based on power limit, and laptops with the newer 3060 have a larger possible power range available. To do this testing, I'm using my Lenovo Legion 5 for the 3060 laptop and the Electronics Max 15 for the 2070, as they both have the highest 115 watt power limits available, though the 3060 can go higher with dynamic boost in certain scenarios. Now, older RTX 2070 laptops are only available with Intel processors. Before AMD's Ryzen 5000, Ryzen 4000 was only available with up to Nvidia RTX 2060 graphics. So basically, because the RTX 2070 graphics are older, they're always going to be paired with an older processor. Unfortunately, this means that some of the differences in this video might be due to the processor differences rather than the GPUs only. It is what it is, but at the same time, I think it's still pretty fair, because if you were to actually buy a 2070 or a 3060, you would get older or newer CPUs respectively. To try and mitigate the processor differences, we'll focus on higher setting presets in games, as those are generally more GPU bound. I should also note that older processor in the 2070 system does also mean slower memory. Again, it's not ideal when trying to focus on GPU differences, but it is an actual platform difference that exists between these two generations. Now, the Legion 5 has a MUX switch, which lets us disable Optimus and get optimal performance in games. So all testing has been done with that, but unfortunately the Electronics Max 15 does not offer this. So in order to bypass the integrated graphics and get the same result, I've tested it with an external screen connected. So basically, just to summarize, while not perfectly ideal, I still believe this is a pretty fair comparison between the 2070 and 3060. So let's start out by comparing 17 different games at two resolutions. Then afterwards, we'll focus on things like pricing and availability. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested with the game's benchmark. I've got the 1080p results below and 1440p results above, with the older RTX 2070 on the bottom and newer RTX 3060 above. The difference was below average out of the 17 games tested at 1080p, with the 3060 coming in 11% ahead of the 2070. But then at the higher 1440p resolution, the 3060 was now reaching 17% higher average FPS, despite the 2070 having more VRAM. This game recently added DLSS support, and this is a feature that both RTX GPUs support. At 1080p, the 3060 was now just 4% ahead of the 2070, so DLSS closes the gap there. Then at 1440p, the 3060 was still 13% ahead. But that said, above 60 FPS at high settings isn't bad or anything from the 2070. Cyberpunk 2077 was tested with the exact same run through the game on both laptops. And at both resolutions, this game had one of the biggest improvements on the 3060 out of all 17 titles tested, with a 38% higher average FPS. Even the 1% lows from the 3060 were higher than the average frame rates that the 2070 was able to offer. This is another game that offers DLSS support, so it's possible to further boost performance with both of these RTX GPUs. But even with it enabled, the 3060 was still more than 30% faster than the 2070. Watch Dogs Legion was actually doing better on the RTX 2070 regardless of resolution, and I believe this is due to the higher VRAM capacity, as there were warnings when running the game's benchmark about the 6GB available on the 3060 not being enough. That said, this is max settings, so we could probably close the gap with lower setting levels. This game also supports DLSS, and at 1440p, the 2070 is able to get an even further lead over the 3060, though both are still, of course, doing better than without it enabled. I've compared control with ray tracing and DLSS, but let's start off with neither, so just stock standard gameplay. At 1080p, even the 1% low from the 3060 was above the average FPS from the 2070, while average FPS was 24% higher. But then at 1440p, they're very close together and basically within margin of error. There's no real difference here. This is another game that supports DLSS, and unlike Watch Dogs just before, the gap at 1440p gets wider in favor of the 3060 this time. But hey, max settings with 60 FPS for the 1% low at this high resolution is still going to play well on the 2070 laptop. Here's how things look with ray tracing enabled but no DLSS, as I just wanted to see pure RT differences. I didn't expect the higher 1440p resolution to be about the same regardless of GPU, as the 3060 has newer RT cores, but here we are. The differences in Microsoft Flight Simulator were above average out of the 17 games tested in favor of the 3060 laptop, though I suspect even at the high setting presets, closer, some of these gains are likely down to the differences in processors. But alas, there's always going to be a CPU difference between these generations of GPUs. The 3060 was 26% faster than the 2070 at 1080p, then a massive 35% faster at 1440p, with a 1% low even above the 2070's average FPS. Call of Duty Warzone had one of the largest differences between these two GPUs at 1080p, with a 39% higher average frame rate on the 3060 laptop, and 37% ahead of the 2070 at the higher 1440p resolution. This was another where even the 1% lows from the 3060 were ahead of the 2070's average FPS. This game also supports DLSS, so both laptops can get a reasonable performance improvement by enabling this simple setting. The 2070 did feel a bit stuttery with max settings at 1440p without it, and although DLSS wasn't a magical cure, it did make it feel noticeably smoother. DLSS is giving a bigger boost to the 3060 though, as it's now 47% ahead of the 2070 here. Fortnite had about average differences between the two laptops when compared to the other 16 games tested. Max settings 1440p was still above 60fps on the 2070 though, but the 3060 was able to offer a 23% boost to average FPS, with a perhaps more important 29% boost to the 1% lows, meaning the 3060 laptop offers a more stable experience. Though more often than not, I've found 1% low differences to depend more on the CPU than GPU. This game also has DLSS support, and the 3060 was still a similar 20% higher in terms of average FPS at 1440p, but the 2070 is able to achieve a nice 47% increase to average FPS by enabling this setting. F1 2021 was tested with the highest setting preset, which enables some ray tracing effects by default, as denoted at the top of the graph. Perhaps this is why this game was one of the larger wins for the RTX 3060, as it does have newer RT hardware built in. The 3060 was reaching 25% higher average FPS at 1080p, and was 31% ahead of the 2070 at 1440p. Assassin's Creed Valhalla had below average differences, with the 3060 just 14% ahead of the 2070 at 1080p, and 18% ahead at 1440p. What I'm more interested in is comparing these results with AMD's upcoming RX 6600M and 6700M, as this game in particular generally has big gains with Radeon graphics, so make sure you're subscribed for those upcoming laptop comparisons. Rather than talk through the rest of the 8 games individually in depth, I'll just blast through them so we can get into the average differences, as that's more interesting. Even if all of this testing did take many hours to complete, a larger selection of games is important to help get a better rounded average. Feel free to pause the video if you want a closer look at these additional games. On average, over all 17 games tested at 1080p, the RTX 3060 laptop was reaching 19% higher average FPS compared to the 2070 laptop. Basically, the 3060 was better in all games, with the one exception being Watch Dogs Legion, which appears to benefit from the additional VRAM present with the 2070. Stepping up to the higher 1440p resolution, and the results are similar. The RTX 3060 laptop was now around 20% faster than the 2070 laptop when averaging out all 17 games tested, and once again just one title was doing better with the 2070's extra VRAM, though Control was close to seeing no difference between them. And that is a relatively GPU-heavy title. For the most part though, the 3060 was now further ahead in most other games. It's also worth mentioning that Nvidia's new 30 series laptops also have extra features like HDMI 2.1, which might be important for you if you plan on playing 4K games at high refresh rate. Just before we get into the price differences, I've also compared both GPUs in some content creator workloads. It's not all just about gaming. The 3060 was almost 50% faster at completing the Blender Classroom test when compared to the 2070, while the shorter BMW test was 55% faster on the 3060. Not too unexpected, given the 3060 has many more CUDA cores, and this is a CUDA test. V-Ray was also better on the 3060, scoring 23% higher in the CUDA test, but the ray tracing test was scoring 65% higher on the 3060, so the RT performance definitely seems to be much better there, which I suppose isn't too surprising given it literally has newer generation RT hardware. But that said, as we saw in games like Control earlier, there were only minor differences at times. SpecViewPerf tests out various professional 3D workloads, and the 3060, shown by the purple bars, was generally ahead in most of these tests. However, the 2070 and the red bars had a couple of wins, perhaps due to the higher VRAM, I'm not sure. Great, so in general, the 3060 does outperform the older 2070. So what are the price differences like, and is it worth buying the 3060? Prices will of course change over time, so refer to those links down in the description below for updates. At the time of recording, Lenovo's Legion 5 that I've tested here goes for under $1,600 for the 3060 model, but I've seen it on sale for as low as $1,400. And it's also worth mentioning, I've seen sales of other models like HP's Omen 15 with 3060 for as low as $1,080. Granted, that one has a lower 100 watt power limit and won't perform as well as the Legion 5, which is more of a best case. As for 2070 laptops, well, just scrolling around new models, they appear to be similar prices, if not more. I'm guessing availability issues with 3060 laptops have kept the price of 2070 models high. Supply and demand. Given the 2070 mobile launched in early 2019, you might have better luck on the secondhand market, as there's probably just more of these machines available, as they were made in a time before supply shortages. Many 3060 laptops, on the other hand, are still hard to buy due to availability issues. Honestly, in terms of gaming performance, I was expecting the differences between these two laptops to be smaller than it was. The 3060 actually surprised me there, particularly at 1440p. I thought the extra VRAM in the 2070 might help it out more. I suppose it's possible that in future, the margins between these two laptops could shrink, particularly at 1440p if the 6GB of VRAM in the 3060 starts becoming a bottleneck in future games. The 2070 is definitely still capable, but my main concern is that the prices of both are generally quite similar. So unless the 2070 is available with a pretty steep discount, you might as well just try and get a 3060 laptop, as it's both going to perform quite a bit better in games, but it's also going to be paired with a more modern CPU. Based on what we've seen here, the 3060 might actually be a better fight for the RTX 2080, something I definitely didn't expect. Let me know in the comments below if that's something you want to see. Check out these other comparisons next if you want to see how well Nvidia's RTX 3060 laptop compares against others. Make sure you're subscribed for future laptop comparisons like this one, there are a lot more on the way. And come and join me in Discord and get behind the scenes videos by supporting the channel on Patreon.